stuck them in the hall, and then at some point, maybe 5-10 minutes before school was supposed to be, she's like, where is, you know, and luckily all the kids remembered where she put him, but she thought he'd left the room without her, and she'd completely forgotten that she'd sent him out to the hall. And I'm like, A, it's not good to do that with parents in your classroom, and B, you really ought to remember where you should be. What we're going to do today is doing more with probability. We may apply rules of conditional probability, but we may not. The reason I say we may is almost everything we do, we can do without using conditional probability formulas. And then we're going to have tree diagrams show up again, because some of the stuff with conditional probability makes a lot of sense in a tree diagram. So tree diagrams and tables both come in. Now, the next conditional probability is we take into account that something has already happened when we find our probabilities. So here are the formulas. And really what's important in these formulas is not the formulas themselves so much as this little symbol here. This set of symbols says, what is the probability of A given that we know that B has already happened? So this line is indicating to us that it's a conditional probability. And this is telling us what we know has already happened. So this is what we're limiting ourselves to look at. And so the actual formula here says, well, that's the number of things in A and B at the same time divided by, in this case, only the number of things in B, not the whole sample space. So we limit ourselves. We limit ourselves from big sample space to a smaller piece of it usually. And then you can rewrite this way as the probability of A and B happening at the same time as the probability of A given that B already happened times the probability of B. But as I said, these formulas are nice, but for the most part, I don't do a single problem where you need them. Now, we're going to ignore that because it doesn't make sense until we get to a tree diagram. So once we've drawn a tree diagram, we'll go back and look at how to read our tree diagram and do probabilities there. For now, we have a newspaper poll and related to violence on television. 600 people were asked, what is your opinion of the amount of violence on primetime television? Is there too much violence? And here's what they said. When they talked to men, they found out 162 of them said, yes, there's too much violence. 95 of them said, no. 23 of them apparently haven't been paying attention, so they don't know. And they talked to 280 total men. When they talked to the women, 256 of them said, yes. 45 said no, and 19 of them were not paying attention, for a total of 320 women. Altogether, 418 people said yes, 140 people said no, 42, just who knows where they are, for a total of 600 people. Every time I think of this, I think of that commercial where the mom is saying to the guy, the soprano guy, I'm sorry, but it's just a little too much, you know, I'm going to have to block you from my kids. But I think, yeah, okay. That mom is obviously right here. So, this table is not actually disappearing, it's just moving up to the top of the page, because we don't need the rest of the words for this. So, our first question is, what is the probability that somebody said yes? Is this a conditional probability, and how do I know? What was my clue that I had a conditional probability? That line thing. Line? No line. So we're not talking about a conditional probability, we're talking about totals. So when I'm looking at the probability that somebody said yes, that's going to be over the total number of people talked to. So, where are the yes people? Because that's what it's asking me. I want to know how many yes people there were out of everybody. There are 418. They're right here. And because we're talking about just people who said yes, we don't care if they were men or women. There are 418 of them. What about... You need to give me one of those things to answer the question. Of course, when I have one of those in a classroom, I don't use it. Or Well, that's it. That's it. But you need to be paying attention.
I need to distract you from learning something.
What's the probability that the person spoken to was a man? Is this a conditional question? Nope. Again, no line, vertical line to indicate conditional. So, again, I'm going to be out of 600 because it's everybody that they talk to. Where are the men? They're in that second row at the end. There are 280 total of them. So the probability that I talked to a man was 280 out of 600. What is the probability that somebody said yes, given that they were a man? Is this a conditional probability? Yes, it's got the line. What is my condition? In other words, what am I limiting myself to look at?
Yes.
Not exactly. What's going on in the bottom? Is it going to be the 600? Just men. This says, I already know I'm talking to a man, so I only look at the men. That means I'm only going to look at that second row where it comes out to a total of 280 people. That's all I'm looking at, is those 280 people. So now that I got the bottom, what's going to be on the top? 162. That's where those people are. People who were men and said yes at the same time.
That wasn't hard.
The next question says, what's the probability that it's a man given that they said yes? Is this going to be the same answer?
No.
Not necessarily. Why were we in the 418? Why did we decide on 418 for the bottom? Right. We're looking, saying, we're only looking at the people who said yes. So that's only this column of people right here. We're not looking at any of the rest of them. So the bottom has 418. And the top would have, let's see, the 162. Because we're looking only at this column. If you're in this column, how many men are there? 162. Notice these two numbers are not the same. If I rearrange my condition and my thing,
whatever you want to call it,
we don't get the same answer. Now,
what about
this one? What's the probability of yes and man? Is that a conditional probability? She gives me all of the possible answers. Yes and man. Conditional or no? Nope, no line. It's an and. So not conditional means I'm talking out of everybody that I talk to. Yes and man. 162, because there are all those are the people who said both were both at the same time. They said yes and they happen to be a man at the